Yes, good evening everyone. Yes, I'm Swati, your science teacher. So I hope you all are healthy and happy at your particular places. You're fine, yes. And today we are going to start with something you must be guessing right now. So what do you see? What is there in front of you? You must have guessed your topic, that is we are going to discuss today, because it is in the continuity. So you must be knowing that what is it by now. Yes, so students, what do you think when you look at this picture? Yes, what do you think? What are there? Yes, I'll give you 5 seconds to make your observations and give your responses. Yes, we can see there are different compartments, right? So, I have made one box in front of you. Yes, this is a whole structure. So when I try to do this, I have divided it into how many parts? Yes, very good students. I have divided it into 2 parts. Now, what do you say now? I have divided it into 3 parts. So we have the top part, then the bottom part, and the middle part. Yes, do we have it? We have these 3 parts. So today, the part that we are going to discuss about is the middle part. So this part, the middle part of the digestive system. That is our topic for today, that we are going to discuss upon. So middle part of the digestive system basically. So this is, we'll be starting with a poem. First, I know there'd be high heaps of congestion if my body just wouldn't engage in digestion. A series of tubes like plumbers have pipe, lets my food move quite raw or quite ripe. Stuff food in my mouth, chew with my teeth. Yes, we'll be moving forward. Add some saliva, the juice it secretes. Swallowing time down the esophagus gets to the stomach. Let's stay on the top of this, stomach's muscles are churning. Break up the food, adding enzymes and acids, and sounds quite rude. The food will move on. Peristalsis will push. The food will move on as it turns into mush. Yes, so this is a poem. What it says? Yes, I know there'd be high heaps of congestion. So high heaps of congestions mean, congestion basically means when there is undigested food in our body. So high heaps of congestion will be, heap means that when something keeps on collecting on top of the other things. So high heaps of congestion if my body just wouldn't engage in digestion. So if there will be no digestion, then we'll be having congestion. No digestion will result into having congestion basically. Congestion, congestion. So we say digestion is necessary to do not, if we want, don't want to have congestion. So a series of tubes like plumbers have pipe. So a series of tube, our digestive system is like a series of tube, one after the other. There are different tubes, just like plumbers are having pipe. Let's my food move. So through those different pipes, the food in our body will be moving quite raw or quite ripe. Yes, sometimes, so half, it will be half raw and half ripe. So it is halfly digested, that will be moving, the food will be moving in our body. Stuff food in my mouth, chew with my teeth. So I will be stuffing the food basically in my mouth and chewing it with my teeth. That is what it is saying. Add some saliva, the juice it secretes. So the mouth is secreting a juice, like juice, that is liquid, that is saliva. Swallowing time. Now there is swallowing time after that juice is being secreted. Down the esophagus gets to the stomach. Now that esophagus which we discussed, that is the pipe that is connecting the mouth and the stomach. So down the esophagus get to the stomach. So esophagus is taking the food from mouth to the stomach. Let's stay on the top of this. Stomach's muscles are churning. So we are saying that the food will stay inside the stomach, inside the top of the stomach, and muscles of the stomach will be basically churning, basically moving. So break up the food, to break up the full, break up the food basically, sorry. To break up the food, the muscles of the stomach will be moving in different directions. Yes. So adding enzymes and acids in stomach, different acids, the most prominent acid that is, there is HCl, that is present to break down the food. Yes. Adding enzymes and acids and certain enzymes that are being released by the glands that are present near it. That is some enzymes are released by the liver, some are released by the pancreas also. And surrounding quiet route and sounding quiet too, because some acids and enzymes are being added. So the food will move on. The food will move on after these enzymes are added and the acids are added to break down the food. Peristalsis will push. So peristalsis will be pushing the food downward, the other pipes that are there. The food will move on as it turns into mush. Yes. So the food will be turning into feces as it will be moving from the mouth towards the anus, or we can say the rectum, that will be coming after the large intestine. So I hope till now this is clear to you. Yes, so we will be moving forward. That is, small intestine comes next. The next organ for fun, nutrients absorbed, and it's almost all done. Large intestine absorbs, removes excess water before food's back out, just like it's outs. Yes, there would be heaps of congestion if my body didn't engage in digestion. Yes. So what comes after the food is being pushed into a mush? Small intestine comes, and the next organ is where other fun is happening. Nutrients are absorbed in the small intestine, and after that, it is almost done now. Now large intestine is coming, that will do the absorption of the excess water that is present in our food, or we can say the fecal matter now, that is going to leave our body. And before food's back out, just like it out, it's outer. Yes, there would be heaps of congestion if my body didn't engage in digestion. So this is an amazing story that is telling us how the digestive system works. I hope you have also found this interesting. So if we talk about the alimentary canal, basically the part of the digestive system, which is the canals, that is mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, and anus, which you may be able to see on the slide as well, that here, this is the oral cavity. Yes, salivary gland is there in this cavity. This cavity is the space between where there is some salivary glands are there. They are releasing the saliva in our mouth, which makes the food that we are eating softer, and it makes it easier to move downward to form the esophagus, basically. Pharynx. So pharynx are some of the face muscles that are behind the basically the oral cavity that is there. Yes. And the salivary glands are there. Then they'll be moving this all structure will be moving the food downwards towards the stomach. Then there will be stomach, that small intestine. In the stomach, we have seen that certain enzymes are and acids will be added into the food that we have eaten, and it will be breaking the food into simpler substances. Yes, simpler units will be there. Then the food will be pushed towards the small intestine, where nutrients will be absorbed. And it's almost done when the food has reached towards the small intestine. So when it will be moving toward the large intestine, so that water, excess water that is present in the food, it will be absorbed in the large intestine basically. Then the food will be pushed down towards the rectum, and then finally it will leave the body through the anus. So I hope this all structure is clear to you now. Yes, so if we specifically talk about this structure, that is position, shape, and function. This is the stomach. So if you talk about stomach, the stomach is a thick walled bag-like structure. Its shape is like a flattened J. So it is looking like a flattened J. Yes, it receives food from the food pipe at one end and opens into the small intestine at the other. The inner lining of the stomach secretes hydrochloric acid and digestive juice that will be helping in the digestion of food, basically to break the complex food substances into simpler ones. The acid kills many bacteria that enters along with the food and makes the medium in the stomach acidic and helps the digestive juices to act, basically. The digestive juices break down the proteins into simpler substances. So the digestive juices are breaking down these proteins into simpler substances. From complex to the simpler substances, the food is getting converted. Yes, so now we know that stomach is having a flattened J-like shape. It receives the food from the food pipe, that is esophagus, from the one end, and opens into the small intestine at the other end. So this pipe that is here will be opening into the small intestine, and this pipe that is esophagus, it will be giving the food towards the stomach. The inner lining of the stomach is secreting, the inner lining of the stomach will be secreting the hydrochloric acid and the digestive enzymes or digestive juices will be saying. So these digestive juices will be having different type of enzymes that will help in digestion of the food. And the other is the next point in the digestive juices break down the proteins into smaller substances. Yes. So we'll be moving forward from here now. Yes, now what is there? How will you explain this picture? This emoticon, how you will be describing it? Yes, this feels like that this person is not able to digest his food or he is suffering from food poisoning. Yes, very good students, he is able to throw up. Okay, we'll be moving forward. You are correct about the picture. Yes, stomach rumble, lunchtime foods. Your stomach is rumbling for healthy food, and circle the foods that drinks that you food and drink that you might find it, that you find that they are healthy. You will be circling the food. Yes, you will be choosing the food. You will be writing in the comment section below that which food out of these are healthy for you. Okay. Yes, very good students. Yes, this radish is healthy. Yes, grapes are also healthy. These are bowl of vegetables. Salad is there. This is also healthy. This is not healthy because this is canned food. Yes, pizza is also unhealthy. So this is an orange, so this is also healthy. Very good students. This is a donut, it is not healthy as well. Very good students, you know what is healthy and what is not. This is a bottle of milk, you are considering this as healthy. Very good. So bread and ham basically. Okay, some are saying it is healthy, some are saying it is unhealthy. So it is not that much healthy and not that much unhealthy as well. You can have it as not frequently, but sometimes you can have it. It will not be creating an issue. So this is a coconut. It is plant based, so it is also healthy. And chocolate is unhealthy. Yes, very good students. So you have identified the healthy and unhealthy stuff that you may have for lunch today. Yes. So we'll be moving forward from here. You did great. Yes. Now you will be giving answer to these questions. I will giving you 10 seconds for one question, that the component of food which is complex is protein, carbohydrates, fats, and or we can say all of above. The components of food which is complex is protein, fat, and carbohydrates, or all above, all of the above. Yes, so I have written all three of them. So who do you think which one is complex? Yes, very good students, you have done right that all of these are complex. So what will be the simpler substances of these? So if you talk about proteins, amino acids, proteins are made up of units of amino acids basically. So they'll be connected units of amino acids. They'll be broken down into, proteins will be broken down into amino acids. If we talk about carbohydrates, they will be, what is it? Their complex form of what? Basically sugars, glucose. So glucose are various glucose, or we can say various sugars are joined to form carbohydrates. Yes, various sugars are joined, so they will be complex form and they will be broken down into different sugars. If we talk about fats, fats are complex forms of lipids and glycerol, basically lipids. Yes, so lipids are joined to form fats. So this will be make broken down into pieces and will be digested in the form of simpler substances, that is different units, that is lipids, amino acids, and glucose basically. Yes, I hope now this is clear to you. And the next question that you will have to answer is, the stomach releases hydrochloric acid and dash juices which acts on food. What type of juices does the stomach releases? You will be giving your answers in the comment section below. Yes, I'll give you 5 to 6 seconds to give answer to this question. Yes, so the answer to this question will be the digestive juices are secreted by stomach along with hydrochloric acid. Yes, so next statement will be yes, working of stomach. There's a bullet and it is pointing towards the, it has shot a gun towards the stomach of the person who is in front. Yes, so how do you think what will happen? Yes, but we'll be reading about it. The working of the stomach was discovered by a strange accident. In 1822, a man named Alexis Saint Martin was badly hit by a shotgun. The bullet had seriously damaged the chest wall and made a hole in his stomach. He was brought to an American army doctor, William Beaumont. So William Beaumont, he was brought to this army doctor. The doctor saved the patient, but he could not close the hole properly and left it bandaged. Beaumont took it as a great opportunity to see the inside of the stomach through the hole. He made some wonderful observations. Yes, Beaumont found that the stomach was churning food. Its wall secreted a fluid which could digest the food. He also observed that the end of the stomach opens into the intestine only after the digestion of the food inside the stomach is completed. So it is saying that after the digestion of the, after the churning, the when the food has been digested in the stomach, only after that, that hole, that path towards the small intestine will be opened by the stomach. So this is what the doctor observed. So we'll be moving forward. Yes, now you will be telling which type of two type of intestine you can see. Yes, sorry for the disturbance. Yes, so the, what two type of intestines you can see? The outer one is the large intestine, very good students, and the inner one is the small intestine basically. Yes, yes, so if we talk about the small intestine, the small intestine is highly coiled and is about 7.5 meters long. It receives secretions from the liver and pancreas. The partly digested food now reaches the lower part of the small intestine, where the intestinal juice completes the digestion of all components of the food. So in the large intestine, now the digestion will be complete. The carbohydrates get broken down into simpler sugars such as glucose, fats into fatty acids and glycerol. Yes, basically the fats are broken down into fatty acids and glycerol, and proteins into amino acids basically. Yes, you will be giving answer to these questions, that what is the length of the small intestine. Yes, I'll give you two to three seconds to give answer to this question. Yes, yes, very good students. So it is 7.5 meters, that is the length of the small intestine. You will be filling this blank, that yes, that it receives secretion from the, yes, you will be telling the answer. Yes, very good students. So it receives secretions from the liver and pancreas. Small intestine is receiving secretion from the liver and pancreas. Yes. Now we can see that there is this sponge that is in front of us. There is this handkerchief is there. Then there is water. Now what do you think, which one will be absorbing the water properly? The handkerchief or the sponge? Yes, very good students. The sponge will be absorbing the water well. So we can say the absorption. So we will be checking how absorption happens in the small intestine. So that is there, that is villi, finger-like projection that are there present in the small intestine basically. Finger-like projections that line wall of small intestine allow food to be absorbed or taken into the bloodstream. So the nutrients from the food will be taken into the bloodstream with the help of these villi that are present on the line wall of the small intestine. It contains blood capillaries and lacteals. So basically there are the blood vessels that are present on the villi that will help in the absorption of the nutrients that are present in the food, and they will be taken towards the bloodstream for our body to uptake them. Yes. Now small intestine contains dash that increases surface area of absorption. Now we have just discussed it, that what small intestine contains that will be increasing the surface area of the absorption in that organ. Yes. Yes, very good students. So that is basically villi. That is the structure that is having villi that will increase the surface area in the small intestine basically to increase the surface area for absorption, so that they will be entering more nutrients in the bloodstream. So the next question is, read the following statements with reference to the villi of small intestine. Now you will be identifying those statements which will enable the villi to absorb the digested food basically. So they have very thin walls. They have a network of thin and small blood vessels close to the surface. They have small pores through which food can easily pass. They are finger-like projections basically. Yes. Okay. Someone is saying that they are having finger-like projection. That is a true statement. Okay. Then you can find, you can search the fourth in which option that fourth option is there. Okay. It is there in everyone, in every option. So you have to find the others. Yes, they have a network of thin and small blood vessels closer to the surface. They have small pores. Okay, you are saying the second and fourth statement are true. Second and fourth are there only in first and the second option. Now you have one option left, that first and the third statement. They have thin walls and they have small pores. Okay, now you are telling that first, second and fourth are true. So that is a true answer. That is the right answer. That is the A, that they have very thin walls. The second, that is they have a network of thin and small blood vessels close to the surface. Then fourth, that is they are finger-like projections. So A option is correct option regarding the absorption in the small intestine through villi. Yes, so we'll do a quick recap of things. So we have discussed about the middle region of the digestive system today, where we have discussed how stomach, how food will be going towards the stomach, and how different enzymes are being released in the stomach, and how the stomach is made of different layers which are releasing different enzymes and different digestive juices in the food, which will be helping in breaking down the complex food into simpler substances, basically breaking the carbohydrates into glucose or sugars, and breaking the fats into fatty acid and glycerol, and breaking the proteins into amino acids basically. So this is how digestion will be occurring in the middle region of the digestive system basically. So the middle region of the digestive system is having the small intestine and stomach. Very good students. The carbohydrates get broken into. So yes, I have given the answer to this question just now. You will be trying to recall that the carbohydrates get broken into. Yes, they are getting broken into glucose, or we can say the smaller sugars. So define the process of absorption. You will be writing your responses in the comment section below, that you will define the process of absorption. I'll give you 10 seconds to do that. Yes, very good students. So absorption occurs how? Yes, with the help of villi, absorption is occurring in the small intestine. Yes, students. The villi is basically increasing the surface area for the absorption through the blood vessels and capillaries. It is passing on the nutrients toward the bloodstream. Yes, very good students. The inner wall of the small intestine have thousands of finger-like outputs, which are known as, what are they known as? Yes, very good. So they are known as villi. Villi are finger-like projections which are helping in the absorption of the nutrients in the small intestine. The homework for you today is that you will find out what vitamins are and what are vitamins, and get the following information, that what are the vitamins which are necessary for the diet. We'll finding it out. Which type of food should be eaten regularly to maintain the healthy digestive system? Yes. And question 2 is, write a 1-page note on the information collected by you. You may take help of a doctor, a dietitian, any other person, or from any other source. The activity that you will be doing is, collect the data from your family members. Neighbors and friends, and write down their name, age and the quality of food or number of meals they take during the whole day. Compare the food quantity they taken by a child. Is it same as the adult or is it different? So how will it be helping in the digestion? If the digestive system of the child is different from the digestive system of the adult, you will be finding that out. So the name of the person, the age of the person, and the quantity of the food they are taking. How digestion is working in different organ, different humans of different age basically. Yes. So this is all about today. I hope you all have understood the concept that we tried to discuss today. Yes. So this is all about the digestive system, the middle region of the digestive system, that is the stomach and the small intestine. We'll be coming again, meeting again in the next class. Till then, if you have any queries, you can write them in the comment section below. I can discuss upon them with you later on. Yes, we'll be meeting again with the next topic today, next topic for the next class. Till then, goodbye students. You were a good sport. Thank you so much.